Yes, hello. As you mentioned already, so there is so many chemicals and cosmetics and plastics on board of this cargo ship that have been released to the ocean now and are washed up to the coastline. And this really is a problem. Just let's look at the pellets. The size of the pellets is a problem for birds and fish. So to all the marine life and all on humans as well. It really can be dangerous. You think plastic isn't dangerous, but in this size and in this amount of pellets, it is. The fire started because there was a leakage of the containment of the nitric acid. And nitric acid, if it is released to the environment, will get hot and can inflame surrounding materials. The container with the nitric acid has been placed below layers of other containers. Well, I'm not an expert on how to place containers, but this is one of the questions. Could this container be removed on time before the whole ship is set on fire and now sunk? Well, it's not a toxic chemical like we know of dioxins or similar materials. But Greenpeace, for example, now expresses the demand that we want to have these pellets treated like hazardous material. And this is because of its size and because of the amount that now has been produced or is produced daily and is shipped around the world every day. And like we see in this case, but we saw it before in other cases as well, if it is released to the environment in such big amounts, it's really a threat to human and to also to marine life. So it is, in a way, it is a dangerous, it is a hazardous material. Yes, sorry. It is heartbreaking, yes, because we're talking so many times about this, and we know that it is a big problem to marine life, for example, and now to see such many of pellets being washed up the coast and how difficult you can see in the videos and the pictures how difficult it is to clean up the coast because these pellets are so tiny, so small. It is really heartbreaking. And let's fingers crossed that the Navy is really successful in cleaning up the coast as soon as possible. But we are really afraid because there is still a lot of material in the water. The ship has sunk today, so we don't know what will happen with all the fuel and the oil on board of the ship. It might be that we have an oil spill and another disaster in a couple of hours or days.